Well, I appreciate you coming by and doing the show.
I've been wondering why you hadn't been asking me.
Well, actually, I have, but you've been gone.
Yeah.
But it's going to be a real special show for me. Sit around and visit you and Jesse here in the control room and talk about everything. Today we're going to solve every problem that the music industry ever had. I figure between you and I, we can do it.
You got it. But we can create more problems than they can ever get out of.
I'll tell you what. We'll talk about... We'll go back to the early 60s when we first met out in Phoenix. You were working at J.D.'s, and I was floating around everywhere. What was the name of that? Was it Magoo's?
Magoo's, yeah. Where we played.
And I was playing at Magoo's, and you was playing at J.D.'s.
It was actually owned by the same people, you know.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, well, he didn't want you to know that right there.
Well, you were making more money than I was. I couldn't figure out why. If I'd have known, I'd say, pay me as much as you pay him, Waylon.
I tell you, I had it made there and didn't know it, you know. I could still live on that, I think. I was running to Willie one time, and I said, Willie, they didn't want me to move to Nashville. And so he said, don't do it. So sure enough, I took his advice and I moved to Nashville.
It was a lot of fun, you know. I miss that. I miss being able to get up on stage and sing songs that are new songs, you know, that are favorites of mine that I've heard on the radio or something. Uh-huh. I miss being able to sing those old Bob Dylan songs.
Yeah, I do too. You know, like you get locked into your records, you know.
Well, you've got to. Somebody paying you a whole lot of money. They expect you to do Luke and Buck, Texas, and Detroit City.
Yeah, I've had that, yeah. I finally got to where I figured out how to do those songs, though. You know, when you get one that you get tired of, what you do is you just kind of slip it in on yourself. You don't do it in the same place every night, and it's a surprise.
Surprise yourself with it.
Yeah, that's it. That's it.
Did you ever record a song that you didn't like?
Yeah, I did. And I love old Chip's Moment. Everything, but Wordlet Surprise. I don't know what. I don't know what come over me. You know, I told Richie one night I was singing that on stage, and I said, I turned around to him, and Richie Albright was a drummer then. I said, Richie, would you tell me, do me one favor? I said, before I ever release a song as a single again, tell me that I've got to sing that song for the rest of my life, because you got to live with them, you know. I kind of eliminated that one out of the repertoire, or whatever you call it.
I was always afraid to record a song I didn't like, for that very same reason.
Well, I wised up after that.
you gotta live with it.
You better believe it. Even, you know, like they say, well, you wrote it. And said, that don't make no good. I don't make no difference. I don't like it. It ain't no good.
I get tired of a lot of songs that I write. I get tired of them before I ever get to record them, before I ever get them finished. I get tired of them during the first bridge.
Well, you know what I do? That's the reason when I go in to record, I very seldom know the songs, you know, because I do get tired of them quick, you know, and I'll start messing with the very thing that I liked about them the best. You know, if I get in there and I know it and we have to keep doing it over and over, after a while I'll start messing with the melody or something out of pure boredom.
You've written some really good songs. Some of the first ones that you wrote, well, I recorded them. I recorded some of the songs that you wrote back in the early 60s because I was really, and still am, probably your biggest fan.
Well, you helped me a lot, too. I don't know if people know you're the ones brought me here or not. And, well, I mean, you're the one brought... Yep, you brought me here. You brought me to Chet's attention, you know. And when you was recording Man Across the Sorrow and Just Satisfy You.
Yeah, and you played on some of my... You played on Streets of Baltimore and a lot of those albums. In fact, we did a duet on Memphis that was way back before anybody was doing duets. It came out in an album. I thought it was great.
I did, too. And I don't know. Chet, I don't know why he didn't release that. Let's release it now. He's gone.
Put it out.
There you go.
Right, left.